Welcome to In Her Voice. My name is Kelly Covert, and I am passionate about helping women live authentically by listening to their inner voice. Get ready to be inspired by women of all walks of life that have set aside their should-be's and not good enoughs and are standing in their true voice, the voice of wisdom that each and every one of us has inside. Hello, you guys. This is Kelly Covert, and I am so excited that you're here and joining me today on In Her Voice. I want to wish you all a happy new year. This is my first solo episode of 2018, and I hope that you guys had a lovely holiday and are ready to hit the ground running in 2018. I really feel like 2018 is going to be a year of action, especially for visionary women like us. And I know that you guys are listening, are like psyched and ready to go. So I have a really great episode for you guys today on the beginner's mind. And I want to tell you what inspired me to talk about this. I went to a networking event last night, and it was all about increasing your productivity and focus. Something, let me just tell you guys, that I could really use. I am not the most focused person that I know, and I'm certainly not the most productive person I know. And a lot of that is because, like, I'm easily distracted. And I think some of that is just because of my personality. Like, I need a lot of space to create things. But I thought, you know, this will be good. I bet that I'll get something out of this. And so I went to the networking event, and it was all women. And the woman who was speaking was very energetic and engaging. And she started getting into the meat of the lecture. And my first reaction was like, oh, this is all stuff that I know. And I was like kind of disappointed. I was like, oh man, I was really hoping like that it would be groundbreaking, like that I would have this huge aha moment and be like, yes, that's the answer to all my problems. And that was kind of my first reaction. And I almost started to check out. I almost like pulled out my phone and just like started to check out. Like, I've heard all of this before. There's not going to be anything new, whatever. And then I just had this, you know, little knock on my heart that said, Kelly, pay attention. There's something here for you. And in that moment, I set an intention to have a beginner's mind. So I want to talk to you about what a beginner's mind is. A beginner's mind is, you know, think back to when you first started learning something new that was like super exciting to you. Maybe it was like you first started digging into self-help stuff, or maybe you started learning a new app on your computer, or you got involved in a new sport like CrossFit or triathlon, or you started thinking about doing a marathon. Whatever it is, like when you first have that topic that you're really excited about, but that you know nothing about, what's the first thing that you do? You like dive in. You want to know everything that there is to know about that topic. And it's all exciting, right? Everything you read, you're like, oh my gosh, yes, I'm going to try that. Yes, this looks really good. Oh my gosh, this sounds amazing. And you have that beginner's mind. You're like a sponge. You're open to so many new ideas, and you're just voracious and just amazed by all of it. I mean, a real true beginner's mind is thinking back to a baby as they grow month by month, how they start to see new things and like laugh at things that are just silly, and they think it's the most hysterical thing ever. It's because it is to them. They've never seen something so funny as their dog licking the ground, you know, or whatever it is that's making them laugh like that. And when we approach things with that beginner's mind, number one, we have great joy because it's all exciting. And number two, we will be so much more available for possibilities within any given circumstance, within any given situation. The other option of that, and this is sort of where I was at the beginning of that meeting, we feel jaded. Like, we feel like I'm an expert at that. Even though I'm not an expert at productivity and not great at staying focused, I have actually done a lot of reading about it, and because it's something that I want to work on. And so because of that, because I have done a lot of research and I have done a lot of reading on this, you know, I think, well, I know all that there is to know about this topic. So what is anybody going to be able to teach me something new? So I almost sort of have this attitude like, yeah, like from the beginning, like, there's nothing that will help me here. I already know all of this. And I think this can be even more true if we're dealing in an area where we are quote unquote experts. You know, maybe that's your expertise at work, or maybe that's in the area of being a parent, although I don't know any parents who would consider themselves to be experts if they're really telling the truth. But, you know, it's easy to get into that space of, well, I already know all of this. I don't have to be here for this because I've heard all of this before and it's not going to help me. But when we approach even those quote unquote old things, even those things that we know a lot about already with a beginner's mind, we can see things in a way that we might not have noticed before. All of a sudden, we open ourselves up and we become available for something new. It's like sending this message out to the universe, like, hey, fill me up. Fill me up with something good right now. And the opposite of that is being closed down, being shut down, not being available for anything new, not being open for anything new. And I don't know about you, but like, I want to be open for that, even if that means coming to the things that I feel like I know already with that beginner's mind. I want to be open to the possibility of something new. It's like, do you guys have this when you go to a hotel? Like if you go to a new hotel, maybe I'm just a weirdo, but what I love to do is I like to like go like look in the bathroom and look at all the soaps that they have. And then like I get the book about the hotel out and I just read through it really quick because I want to know if there's a pool, even if I'm not planning on swimming. I want to know if they have room service and what hours those are, or maybe if they have a free breakfast. And, you know, that's exciting to me. It's like every time I go to a hotel, everything's brand new and I want to learn about it. And when you do things like that, you have amazing experiences. One time, I remember I was working at a Rev3 triathlon, and it was in the Poconos in Pennsylvania, and we stayed at this really cool hotel. And I did my thing, like I went into the room and I was reading all of the little papers, and I found this like cool thing that said, they have a variety of pillows available for you and that you can choose your pillow. And that if you don't like the pillow that you have, they like had all these kinds of pillows, like they had names and stuff. Then you can just call down to the front desk and have them bring up a pillow that you want. I was like, that's the coolest thing ever. And of course, like I was like, well, I think I need this kind of pillow. And I called down and they like 10 minutes later brought me up my fancy pillow. And it was wonderful. And so I never would have had that experience if I just expected it to be like every hotel. I went in with a beginner's mind. So maybe you're wondering, how do I develop this beginner's mind? If I'm not used to being in the practice of having a beginner's mind or even being aware of what that means, how do I start? I think one of the best things that we can do, which is what I did at that meeting last night, was set an intention. Set an intention to have a beginner's mind. Set an intention to hear the things that are coming in to you as though you've never heard them before. And just by just doing that, that one small thing, you will be amazed at how much that changes your attitude and your experience in these situations. Another really great way to develop a beginner's mind is to be fully present. So last night I could have pulled out my phone and started scrolling, or they had given us these magazines on everyone's seats. I could have like started like paging through the magazine and I would have been in the room, but I wouldn't have been present. But because I set that intention and I forced myself, and at the beginning I have to admit I was kind of forcing myself to be present, to be there, to listen, to be engaged, then I was able to hear something new. I was able to have that download of, hey, this is something that I want to talk about on the podcast. Even that idea was because I set that intention to have a beginner's mind. I love also this tool of expectation. So sometimes we expect too much and our expectations can get in the way of our joy. But also I think if we go into a situation that we may not be like super excited to be in, you know, think about going into a meeting at work or having a budget meeting with your partner or whatever, you know, having a meeting with your kids' teachers at school. It can be something that we're not really looking forward to, right? But if we go in with this expectation that we're going to really get something great out of that, an expectation of receiving something good, an expectation of learning something new in that meeting, or maybe it's even of just finding something out about a person that you didn't know before, that expectation will increase our presence in the meeting or wherever we are. And it's going to increase what we take away, and it's going to increase our joy and attitude level during the event itself. So I love that idea of setting an expectation that you're going to take something away from whatever situation you're in, and it's going to be really valuable to you. And the last tool that I have, and this is something that we all can use in every area of our life, and that's to let go of shoulds. Let go of your shoulds. Sometimes we go into situations thinking that it should be a certain way, or even approaching a solution to a problem. We think it has to look a certain way. And when we put shoulds on our lives, we're like putting ourselves in jail. We're saying it can only be this one way and that every other way is wrong. And we're stifling our ability to be creative. We're stifling our ability to come up with something new and amazing. So just last night at that meeting, I could have shut myself down and I would have left and I would not have had this idea to share this with you on the podcast. And also I wouldn't have had as much fun at the meeting. And also I wouldn't have come away with a new tool or strategy that I will absolutely be implementing in my life to increase my productivity and focus, because I wouldn't have been expecting that. And I would have been thinking, well, it should be this way, right? So it just really, when we have that beginner's mind, it opens us up to so much possibility. And I love that. And having a beginner's mind, just like anything, is a practice. It's something that we practice. If you're not used to having that, it's not going to be automatic. So maybe set an intention for the next time that you're going into a meeting or even just sitting down to read a book or to watch a TV show or something, to open yourself up to having a beginner's mind. Set that intention. Be present. Expect something new and valuable to come in, and let go of what you think things should be or should look like, and see what happens. And in case you guys are wondering, my big takeaway from the meeting last night was this idea that while you're working, to have a distraction to-do list. So I don't know about you, and I'm sharing this because I feel like I was talking about it so much, I want to share you what my big takeaway was. And when I'm working, especially at the computer, I get so distracted. Like I will go down a rabbit hole for like an hour of like, oh, well, if I do this, then what would happen? And then I have to Google that. And then I have to do that. And the presenter had this great idea to have just a sheet of paper or have your planner or whatever next to you. And when you have an idea of something that you want to research or look into, or something that would be a distraction to the project that you're working on currently, write it down in a list. And then the next time you take a break, you've got your list of like, okay, now I can go in and I can research this and that, and I can look into that, and then I can do this thing. And so you can really be a lot more productive and get a lot more done that way. So that was my big takeaway from the meeting, in addition to this idea of just approaching all of our work and really life with the beginner's mind. Think of how much joy and laughter and happiness that will bring to you. As always, you guys, I am so excited that you're here, that you're listening. And I want to remind you that my personal theme this month is connection. And that means that I want to connect with you. It is my goal. I have a goal this month to learn at least 5 names of listeners that I do not know yet. So those of you who know me, always I want to hear from you. You know that. But if you're listening to this and you have never had a communication with me, will you please send me an email at kelly@kellycovert.com? Let me know who you are. Let me know how you found In Her Voice. And tell me a little bit about yourself. Who are you being in the world this year? What are you working on? What's your big vision? I want to know the answer to these things, and I want to know your name. And so shoot me an email, or another way to connect with me is to connect with me on Instagram at Kelly J. Covert. And I'm going to put links to both of those things in the show notes. So you can go right to your podcast app and click on either my email, shoot me an email right from your phone, or click on over to Instagram and shoot me a message and connect with me there. And just let me know who you are. Let me know your name. I'd love to see a face. That's why I love Instagram so much. Take a picture and shoot me a message saying, hey, because that's my goal for this month. And I feel like 5 is not very many, but I wanted to set very realistic goals. But oh my gosh, wouldn't it be amazing if I got 20 or 25? So if you're hearing my voice right now and you know that we've never connected on a personal level, let's do that. Shoot me an email, kelly@kellycovert.com, or connect with me over on Instagram at Kelly J. Covert. So as always, you guys, I want to remind you that when you come into this world with a beginner's mind, that opens you up to possibility. And those possibilities open you up to greatness, because you were born to be great, each and every one of you. You matter. You were brought to this earth for a reason. And I believe that. And I cannot wait to see what you will do with that. You are worthy.